Say you're asked to synthesize this monstrosity from 2-butanone or this molecule from propanol. There are many ways to approach it, but in this Layer for Sci video, we'll focus on Grignard reactions with a few key shortcuts to add to your retrosynthesis arsenal. Let's take a look at what happens when a Grignard reacts with formaldehyde, an aldehyde, a ketone, or a carboxylic acid derivative like an ester. Starting with formaldehyde, the mechanism between a Grignard and a carbonyl is pretty similar, even if the molecule is different, as I teach on my website linked below at layerforsci.com/grignard. We have a partially positive carbonyl carbon double bound to a partially negative oxygen. The R group on Grignard acts as a carbanion, and will use the electrons that binds carbon to magnesium to attack the carbonyl carbon. We now have too many bonds on carbon, and so the pi bond gets kicked up onto the oxygen. As a result, the oxygen now has its two original lone pairs along with the new lone pairs from the collapsed pi bond, giving it a negative charge, and the former carbonyl carbon now has a new bond to that Grignard R group, in this case a CH3. To get rid of that negative oxygen, we react with a weak acid, which we can show as H3O+, so that oxygen reaches for the proton. The bond between hydrogen and oxygen collapses back onto the oxygen. For a neutral alcohol where the carbonyl used to be, and this is how it looks in line structure. An aldehyde follows the same mechanism, where the Grignard carbon attacks the carbonyl, kicking up the pi electrons to give me an O- and a new bond to the Grignard carbon. Add an acid to protonate, and we get an alcohol for the final product. A ketone will follow the same mechanism, where the Grignard attacks the carbonyl carbon, kicking up the pi electrons, to give me a negative oxygen and a new bond to the Grignard carbon, followed by protonation to give me a neutral alcohol. So far, so good. Do you notice how the mechanisms are exactly the same? This changes slightly when we have a carboxylic acid derivative, such as this ester. The reaction starts out the same way, where the Grignard carbon will attack the carbonyl, breaking the pi bond and collapsing those electrons onto oxygen. This gives me an oxygen with 3 lone pairs and a negative charge, and a new bond to the Grignard's R group. The difference here is that unlike the previous reactions where all carbon had was a bond to carbon or hydrogen, here we have a bond to oxygen, which is a potential leaving group. And the negative oxygen takes full advantage of that by taking the lone pair, collapsing back down to reform the carbonyl, kicking out that OR group. Our resulting molecule has the initial carbon chain with a double bond to oxygen and the incoming Grignard R group. Off in solution, we have an OR-, this time OCH3. But remember, if we're in a Grignard solution, we have more molecules of Grignard floating around. And what happens when you have a Grignard in the presence of a ketone? That Grignard will attack. It doesn't care that you started with an ester. All it knows is there is a reactive ketone, and it wants to attack. Once again, the pi bond collapses upward to give us an O-. We have the initial methyl group from the first Grignard attack and a second methyl group from the subsequent Grignard attack. And now that oxygen can't come back down because there's nothing else to kick out. So it'll wait for us to add acid in the next step, grab a proton, and give us a neutral alcohol product. Let's look at the products again. Where the formaldehyde gave us a primary alcohol, the aldehyde gave us a secondary alcohol, the ketone gave us a tertiary alcohol, and the carboxylic acid derivative ester also gave us a tertiary alcohol. The difference between the ketone and the ester is that the ketone only had one incoming R group. The ester has 2 incoming R groups, which looks the same here, but if I were to change the ketone molecule, notice that we can have 3 different R groups on that tertiary alcohol. But if I change the ester R group, we have 1 that can be different and 2 that are the same because the same Grignard attacked. Once you recognize this, you can very easily understand the shortcut as follows. Going back to the initial problem, here's the pattern you want to look for. Identify the carbon that holds the alcohol and look for the carbon chain that we started with. And recognize that it used to be a carbonyl. Aldehyde, ketone, ester, doesn't matter. This depends on what we started with. Next, look for the carbons that were added. In this case, if we had a ketone numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, where carbon 2 holds the carbonyl, that would be here, 1, 2, 3, 4, showing me that the new bond is between this R group and the ketone. And where you broke that bond is where you want to add MgX to give us our Grignard. So what did this reaction look like? For this molecule, we simply reacted with a Grignard sitting on a benzene ring, for example, MgCl. Same thing for the second molecule. Identify carbon holding the oxygen. Give that a pi bond to form a carbonyl. Identify which carbons were on the carbonyl so that you know what came in as a Grignard. Here we have 1, 2, 3, where carbon 1 is the carbonyl. The molecule is symmetrical, so I can go to either side. Break the molecule between the carbonyl and the incoming R group, in this case the ethyl, telling me that I reacted with an ethyl Grignard. Are you with me so far? If yes, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Then hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. And let's take the shortcut to the next level. Let me show you how to identify exactly what happened. If I have a primary alcohol, and that's my carbonyl breaking off the Grignard, it had to come from a formaldehyde because I have no other carbons on this chain. For my secondary alcohol, I had to start with an aldehyde because I only have one R group remaining. For the tertiary asymmetrical alcohol, I have my carbonyl, and any one of these R groups could have come from a Grignard, but only one, telling me that it came from a ketone. And a tertiary symmetrical alcohol, where I have at least two of the same group, tells me that I could have come from a ketone where one of the R groups attacked, or I could have come from a carboxylic acid derivative like an ester, where both of these came in with a back-to-back Grignard attack. For even more on Grignard reactions, mechanisms, and the reaction cheat sheet, visit my website link below or go to leahforsci.com/Grignard. Again, that's leahforsci.com/Grignard.